There is a text-to-speech model that is going viral right now. A lot of people are getting excited about this one. It is open source, and it's taking on competitors like ElevenLabs, which is the king of the hill right now when it comes to text-to-speech. There's also Sesame, which went viral some time back for their very convincing, realistic, lifelike text-to-speech model. But this new one is called DIA 1.6B. It's from a company, a relatively unknown company called Nari Labs, and it's super tiny. It's just 1.6 billion parameters. And they're actually claiming, a lot of people are claiming that it's better than ElevenLabs. I'm not so sure about that one. We're going to be analyzing that claim as well as the claim that it might be better than Sesame in this video and comparing these models side by side. So stick with us. It's going to be interesting. However, unlike ElevenLabs, this is actually open source under an Apache 2.0 license. You can see that it also generates sounds like laughs and sniffs. These are human sounds that aren't necessarily words or direct speech, but they are important to convey certain emotions and present certain scenes. You can see here there's also emotions that are being conveyed by this model, and you can copy an existing voice. And also, this model is effectively real time on larger GPUs, which is pretty impressive, because using ElevenLabs for the last couple of months, I've noticed that it takes quite a while to generate the audio that you're trying to create when you input text for this text-to-speech model. So it seems like a lot of those issues are solved with DIA. But don't take my word for it. Let's actually give this a listen. It's pretty intense. This is actually the example that they give on their Hugging Face as well. So it's a little bit surprising because it's a bit of an intense scene, but I think they are trying to convey the fact that this AI model can generate audio that sounds very convincing, especially on the emotional spectrum. The characters that you're about to hear sound like they're genuinely in distress. So like, caution is advised here. If this, you can see the text here, if this seems like something that might make you uncomfortable, maybe don't listen to it, but I'm just gonna play it because it is showcasing this model's capabilities. And again, this is what they want the world to listen to for some reason. So let's give it a listen.
My goodness, what's the procedure? What do we do, people? The smoke could be coming through an air duct.
Oh my god, okay, it's happening. Everybody stay calm.
What's the procedure? Everybody stay fucking calm. Everybody fucking calm down.
No, no, if you touch the handle, if it's hot, there might be a fire down the hallway.
Oh, fire.
Hey there.
Did you just call?
Why did you just sniff?
Why did you just clear your throat?
Why did you just laugh?
Nicely done.
Pretty amazing. I haven't heard anything like this from ElevenLabs or really any other voice model that I've tested out. This is text to speech. So it's not like it's taking an existing recording and then turning that into a slightly different style that's AI generated. This is literally just text to speech, and it's doing its best to generate something that aligns with the instructions that are being given to it. Now, diving into some of the technical information about this model, we can see here that the pre-trained model checkpoints and inference code are available on Hugging Face. There's also a demo comparing it with ElevenLabs Studio and Sesame CSM-1B, which is a text to speech model that went viral some time ago because of how realistic it was. The model currently runs on GPUs, but there will be future support for CPUs, and it comes with, of course, detailed installation instructions. Now, looking at this model's GitHub repository, we can see it has 2.7K stars, and it's kind of blown up in just the last 48 hours, really. It seems to be doing quite well, and I think the idea here, the thing that people are excited about, is the fact that it is actually looking to be a competitor to ElevenLabs and potentially also Sesame too. And then also, just in case you're interested, if this is something that is exciting to you, you can join their Discord server as well to stay up to date with what they're working on. So now let's actually check out their Hugging Face here, and you can see that there is already some input text that they've put in. Anything within these squared brackets will not be included in the generation. It just helps the model to understand who's speaking at any given time. So I'm just gonna click generate audio and see what we get. Now we're gonna hit play and—
DIA is an open weights text to dialogue model. You get full control over scripts and voices. Wow, amazing. Try it now on GitHub or Hugging Face.
Yeah, that sounded a little bit strange. The laugh was kind of convincing, but somehow it's moving very quickly through the generation. And so they don't, the pauses between sentences and words feel a little bit rushed, in my opinion, a little choppy, almost like someone did an edit in post-production. So I'm just gonna ask ChatGPT to help me create a more complex prompt that'll give us a better idea of how this thing performs, something a little bit more creative. Help me create an interesting script for a text-to-speech AI model using the following format. I'm just gonna paste it in here and make sure it's dramatic and intense. And let's hit send and see what we get. Okay, this should be interesting. Let's paste this into the Hugging Face and hit generate. We've got a couple of things here. We've got whispering, we've got a low laugh, which is pretty specific. And so I'm very curious to see how it turns out, if it's able to match those kinds of tones. We've heard laughing, we've heard this sniffing thing, we've also heard shouting, but I definitely haven't heard any whispers and I haven't heard any low laughing at this point. So yeah, it'll be interesting to see if Nari can actually handle this new kind of input. All right, let's give it a try and see.
The veil between silence and speech has been torn.
DAIA is an open-weights text-to-dialogue model engineered for total vocal freedom.
You mean full control? Every script, every voice, ours to command?
Yes, no gatekeepers, no locked presets. You write it, DAIA speaks it.
This changes everything.
Upload it, generate it, push it to the edge.
We're not just making voices anymore, we're making choices.
Try it now on GitHub or Hugging Face before someone else does.
I think the vibe that I'm getting from this model is like, and this was at, this was at half speed too. Let's go full speed and see what it sounds like.
The veil between silence and speech has been torn.
DAIA is an open weights text.
Doesn't sound any different, but I think the strange thing here is that it definitely feels like chipmunk voice almost, like they're speaking too quickly and it's like at 1.5x speed or 2x speed. It's almost like the AI is just rushing through the generation, which is a little bit surprising. Definitely not what I'm used to from Sesame, from OpenAI's voice models, or from ElevenLabs for that matter, either. It would be great to have a slider as well. I think down here we have the option to change the parameters. So maybe we can just speed factor. Okay, let's try to reduce this down to the lowest level. And we're gonna hit generate again and just see if it sounds a little bit more natural, a little bit more normal.
The veil between silence and speech has been torn. DAIA is an open weights text to dialogue model engineered for total vocal freedom. You mean full control? Every script, every voice, ours to command? Yes. No gatekeepers, no locked presets. You write it. DAIA speaks it. This changes everything. Upload it, generate it, push it to the edge. We're not just making voices anymore, we're making choices. Try it now.
It is slower, but it's also quite a bit lower as well. It kind of feels unnaturally low, like someone with an extremely deep voice. So yeah, it did slow it down, but with that sort of unfortunate aspect to it. So this is kind of strange to play around with. I don't think I would be able to use this on a regular basis, but it is very compelling when it comes to these special emotions or special sounds, right? When it comes to the coughing from earlier or whispering or sniffing or that low laugh, it's very convincing. I just wish that the model didn't speak so quickly. Now, there's also a post about this on Hacker News, and there's some interesting information here that I'd like to go through. First of all, it seems like it struggles with pauses in the middle of a sentence. So that's an interesting observation. There definitely seems to be a couple of things that the model struggles with, right? The one that I identified was speed. Here, people are talking about pauses. And then also, there's this comparison to ElevenLabs. This user here is talking about ElevenLabs specifically and this comparison where ElevenLabs kind of is the OpenAI, the ChatGPT of text-to-speech. And they're making lots of money from this, right? It would cost something like $100 to generate multiple hours of audio using ElevenLabs through the website or their API. However, you can actually use their Eleven Reader, which is a dedicated app, to generate audio for free. And if you actually just record the audio yourself, you can get it for free, which suggests that their inference costs aren't really that high. They wouldn't be giving away that much audio for free if it was really expensive for them to produce that audio. So it seems like it's actually not that expensive. And yet still, a lot of people are using ElevenLabs because they don't know if there's any other alternatives out there. And so potentially, this could be one of the alternatives. Text-to-speech models just haven't had their stable diffusion moment yet, and it's time that we got one. All it would take was someone to do an open weight model, applying the lessons that we learned from LLMs and image generation to text-to-speech models, more data, more scraping, more GPUs, and less qualms about safety. Now, we've got another user here who's testing the model out, so let's listen to what they've generated. It seems like they are actually running it themselves. This is 90 seconds on Google Collab T4 GPU. So let's play this and listen to what the model can do. And it seems like this generation is also pretty intense, very animated, excited. So it'll be interesting to see how far this person can push the model.
Woohoo! Is this really working?
Looks like it is!
Let's go get some beers then!
Are you sure? It's not even 10:05.
Of course!
All right, fine. But just one, or maybe two.
That's the spirit! Let's make it a party!
Woohoo!
These kinds of generations, I think it works a little bit better due to the fast-paced nature of the output. Because the scene is quick and fast and excited, it feels natural. But then when you try to create a scene that feels more quiet and peaceful and relaxed, that's where you start to run into that speed issue. So we've heard a couple of examples from Nari from DIA 1.6b. We've understood what it sounds like, what it's capable of, but I think it is interesting to compare to existing models. So let's take a look at what Sesame CSM 1B does with that same script. And it's very, very different.
Fire, oh my goodness. What's the procedure? What do we do, people? No. The smoke could be coming, Grenette? I know.
Oh my God. Okay. It's happening. Everybody stay calm.
What's the procedure?
Everybody stay.
Everyone stay calm. I mean, this model is very calm, even though it's clearly an emergency.
Fucking calm.
No.
That at the end is really strange. And again, let's just play. Let's play the DIA 1.6b again, just to give you a comparison here.
Oh, fire! Oh my goodness! What's the procedure? What can we do, people? The smoke could be coming through an air duct.
It's way more convincing. It's way more realistic. It feels like something that you would hear someone actually saying in a voice recording from an emergency situation. Now, Sesame is one thing, but I think it's also worth comparing it to ElevenLabs. So let's take a look at another generation here, and we'll see how Nari compares to ElevenLabs.
Aya is an open weights text to dialogue model.
Generate ultra realistic dialogue like this.
Uh-huh.
Also get full control over scripts and voices.
Wow, amazing.
Try it now on GitHub or Hugging Face.
How does it hold up to
It's a little bit caffeinated. It's a little bit high, you know, fast paced. It feels a little over the top. But it's exciting. It's interesting to listen to.
ElevenLabs Studio and Sesame 1B.
Well, listen and decide for yourself.
DIA was built by a tiny team of two people with no funding.
Whoa, really?
Pretty crazy, huh?
Progress in open source AI is completely crazy.
Yeah.
Even this conversation was AI generated.
What?
DIA was built by a tiny team of two people.
So this is ElevenLabs now.
With no funding.
Whoa, really?
Pretty crazy.
Oh.
Progress in open source. AI is completely crazy.
It feels very slowed down. There's a lot of gaps between things, between words, between sentences. Even the way it said AI, you know, instead of AI, the way that most people would say it.
Yeah.
Even this conversation was AI generated.
What?
DIA was built by a tiny team of...
And again, here is Sesame.
Or with no funding.
Bolts. I get pretty
crazy.
Huh? Progress in open source AI is completely crazy. Yeah. Even this conversation was AI generated.
It feels kind of muffled, kind of muted, and way too casual, which might be what the model is going for. They're trying to achieve a more authentic vibe, maybe almost the way it would sound if you were talking to someone through a phone. over a call. Maybe that's what they're going for, kind of like a slightly muffled sound, the way that you would normally talk to somebody. But it's just not as compelling when you put it next to ElevenLabs and also Dia. Now, the way that this is starting out is this open source model. And that's super exciting for the developer community, for businesses that want to take advantage of this moment in time. However, later on, Nari has some pretty big plans, actually. It seems like they want to build some kind of platform or app specifically to share audio generations with friends, remix what other people have created, generate interesting conversations in seconds, which is what the model can already do. But the way they're looking at this is audio entertainment. And so you can join a waitlist for whatever that ends up being, whether it's an app or a website or some other kind of platform, and then add your email here to stay up to date with what they're working on. Kind of interesting, not sure where it's gonna go, but again, if you wanna check this out, you can head over to their GitHub repository and actually make use of this model for yourself. So if you enjoyed this video, if you found it useful, definitely leave a comment down below. Let us know what we can improve on as well as what you liked. And then also please do hit subscribe if you enjoyed it and hit the like button. All right. Thanks so much for watching. We'll catch you in the next one.